The buy now, pay later industry is booming, fuelled in part by the cost of living crunch. The easy form of credit is luring vulnerable Australians into debt, prompting law changes and a federal government crackdown.
It's been growing out of control. Perth mum Crystal Brown now has to use Afterpay for essentials like nappies. She says she's bankrupt, but it's one of the few lines of credit still open to her.
Not fun, but it is what it is. I don't like to be dependent on many things, if anything, but Afterpay is definitely something that we can't live without at the moment.
This sort of thing has the government worried. Buy now, pay later was never meant to be relied on like this, and the laws are too weak to keep out predators.
Well, that's going to change. Today, the Albanese government is announcing that we intend to bring Buy Now, Pay Later into the National Consumer Credit Act. What will that mean for consumers?
It'll mean mandatory credit licences for all providers, responsible lending rules, dispute resolution and hardship options for people struggling to pay, and restrictions on marketing and advertising. Zip is a $400 million ASX giant. Co-founder Peter Gray says his company already does those things, so he backs the law change.
Very much so. We think it's great for the industry and all participants. We believe the outcome they've landed on is the most sensible approach.
This has been a booming financial grey area. Companies like Afterpay, Zip, Klarna, OpenPay, Hum, Splitit, Latitude Pay, the list goes on and on. They've signed up more than 7 million Australians, but financial counsellors say the system causes damage.
We won't get another chance at this for a long time, so we've got to get this right.
The federal government plans to introduce the changes to Parliament by the end of the year. Chris Kohler, Nine News.